founder of Barstool Sports, Dave Portnoy. Good to have you on the show.
Thanks for having me.
Why is this resonating way beyond a business story?
It's beyond business because you had it, this story went viral. The GameStop stock went viral and the others around AMC. So everyday people were investing in it. It wasn't just Wall Street. It wasn't even just day traders. This hit the general public. We were getting emails from, you know, people who have nothing to do with the stock market were investing money to get on this trend. And then right when they got on it, it's when it plummeted because Robinhood stopped it. So a lot of people lost a lot of money, and people who weren't used to being in the stock market, and people who, I guess, weren't expecting to it go down that way. So it became a much bigger story because it involved everybody, not just traders.
Let's talk about the good guys and the bad guys here. I saw you on another program. You were heated up. You were talking about the anger towards the elites and the big shots and the Wall Street types. And that is catchy. People are angry. And I watched now on these chat rooms, you know, a lot of followers of yours, that's working for them. What is your message about the anger and people seeing going and investing in big groups to fight off the elites? What is the message there?
Well, I mean, my main message has not changed. And I've heard what everybody said. And I saw the interview you had with Vlad, and I saw the interview he had with Elon the other night. And his tune has changed. He went from saying not validity, no outside pressure, to, you know, now it was a liquidity issue in the 3 million.
There had to be a liquidity issue. It had to be. It had to be that he couldn't make the call on covering the margin accounts. And he didn't have the bandwidth. He didn't have the personnel. And he decided to play it safe. But nobody told him to do it. He wasn't forced to do it. So that was always going to be his problem. But it's how it resonated. Speak to that.
Yeah, well, he should have said that in the beginning. But yeah, it makes it seem like he wasn't telling the truth in the beginning. And the facts of the matter is anybody who looks at the people involved, you have the Melvin Capital, you have, you know, the Citadel, you have Steve Cohen, anybody, when you look and connect dots, if you are a rationally human thinking human being, you think I got screwed, and you think the little guy got screwed. And if it was reverse and the big guy and the hedge funds were making billions, nobody presses the pause button. That's what everybody thinks. That's what I think. And that's what I still think, because it's just rationally how you expect it. Nobody's protecting. I've never heard, oh, the big guys are making too much money too quickly, so we got to stop. I also still haven't been answered why, when you said you couldn't buy the stock, or are you allowed to sell it? What I read in the interview and heard with Elon is Vlad said, well, people get very angry and upset if they have to hold the stock and can't sell it. Well, what do you think they're going to do when you cratered it? So there's a lot of things to me that still just don't add up.
Right.
And again, if you're using logic and reason, they'll never add up.
Now, here's my concern. You have a lot of followers, and I think it's good that you've put money into a fund that people can see online, that you're donating to small businesses. I think you put up like 400, 500 grand, and now it's at like 34 million when I checked before the show. Good to help small businesses. They follow you. You take a hit. You've taken them before. You know the risk. You've got the capital behind you. You can take a big hit. A lot of these people are putting a lot of money that they need on the line. Are you worried about them?
No, because here's the thing. Everybody knows the risk. When you say things like that, I've heard it many times, we're treating these people like infants. I mean, it's very straightforward that there's a stock market can go up and down. What is different here? And I didn't know this, to be honest, either. I didn't know that you could stop trading like how they did. I don't think anybody knew that you could do that. So for a lot of people, the rules changed. We're fine doing risk. We're fine putting the money in, but we think we're playing under a set of rules that exist one way. And in reality, they didn't. We didn't know that. I didn't know that. But as far as people risking their money, I've been doing this almost for a year, and I've heard every old school trader and old Wall Street say is going to end in a tier of in tears, and you're leading these people to doom. Facts are, we've been more right than anybody else. So, you know, it's a risk. You have to know. And I always say, same breath, don't put in more than you can lose. Never do that. That's rule one of trading, gambling, investing, anything.
But it's intoxicating, right? I mean, that's when it gets risky, is that it seems like it's going up. Look where the stock is right now. We both know. There's no argument on the fundamentals. There's not even any rational P.E. ratio argument to be made. What happens when it comes down if the investors that, you know, you're rallying up don't have the timing or the wherewithal to get out before the big guys can?
Well, yeah, and that's exactly what happened, because they pressed pause. But the rally's already coming. When it comes to my attention, it's already coming. And the internet is a new age where everybody already hears this stuff. But I have just a different fundamental belief. It's not my job. I can say my opinion, and I believe that people listening to me have brains that work and can decide what they want to do with their own money.
Dave, you're persuasive. When people talk about you, you're not just another guy mouthing off. They listen to you. They believe in what you're telling them. You're giving them a sense of cause. I'm not saying this as a criticism. I'm offering it as a word of caution because they are going on what you say, and in a way, that's what you should want. But you know that they're playing with pros out there now, and somebody's going to lose because this stock can't stay where it is.
Well, it only didn't stay where it is because there was devious behavior involved. I think it would have. But again, as me, if you look at my profile on Twitter, the number one thing it says, I'm not an advisor, don't take anything. I'm pretty clear with that. But if people want to follow what I'm doing, if I wake up and I see a deer outside my door and I say, I'm going to buy John Deere because I saw a deer and I think it's a sign, and somebody wants to jump in on that, well, then you're a moron if that's truly why you believe that's going up. I believe people are smarter and can make decisions for themselves.
I always hope you're right. I always bet on people. Let me ask you something. What are you doing right now? Are you staying in those stocks? Did you make this move to silver that was all over the chat boards?
I didn't do silver. I still have the others. I actually said today, I think I'm paying the highest price just to make memes. I like saying I'm holding it. It's going to the moon. And meanwhile, it's going down and I don't know what's going on. But if you watch the stream, I openly say that. So I still have AMC. I still have Nokia. I've gotten killed on those. I've gotten absolutely murdered.
So why do you have them?
Because I'm not going to get rid of them. I like being part of the movement right now, and I like making memes about it.
All right. Well, you can do that. Not everybody can. Dave Portnoy, thank you for tracking this story with us. I appreciate it.
Thanks.